I must tell you that a lot of people did not like my work because we were taking note of Hindutva politics. And I may also add here that the real purpose of all this propaganda against me was to deny me a second term.
So we have with us today the Delhi Minority Commission Chairman, Dr. Zafarul Islam Khan. Sir, thank you so much for joining us. Sir, this is regarding your tweet for which you've been booked for sedition by the Delhi police. Sir, can you, you put that tweet out on the 28th of April, which got a lot of attention, a lot of criticism. Then you put a series of tweets after that. You put another tweet defending it. Then you put another tweet out clarifying it. And you also said you also apologized to people, to all those whose sentiments were hurt. This is the line from your tweet. And then on May 3rd, again, you said that you do not apologize for it. So before we move ahead, I want to understand what is your stance currently on that tweet and what was this tweet about?
See, the tweet was about the Kuwaiti government's decision to take note of in quotes, persecution of Muslims in India. They sent a letter to their foreign minister to take note of this decision and to talk to the world community. I thought that I should thank them for taking note of what is going on here. And then I said, what is the reason of them taking note? That Indian Muslims enjoy a lot of goodwill in the Arab world. So the last paragraph was that if Indian Muslims choose to complain to the Arab world or Muslim world, there will be an avalanche for Hindutva. That is the word that I've used. Hindutva bigots. Not for Indians, not for Hindu. Then within hours, or rather within 1 or 2 hours of this, some channels picked it up and said that Islam Khan, who is so and so, he is inviting foreign intervention in India, and he is saying that if Indian Muslims ever complain, there will be an avalanche for Indian bigots. I never said that.
You said in your tweet, that last paragraph, which is what is being misunderstood or which is what is being blown out of proportion, is that the last line, I'll read verbatim, and I have your the statement in front of me from the 28th of April. It says, the last line is, the day they are pushed to do that, bigots will face an avalanche. I wanted to ask you why you would say something like this.
You see, you can say it was an indiscretion. It is possible. Yes, I accept that. I should not have said that. And I realized 2 days later that I should not have said this. And I in another tweet, I said that it was insensitive and it was ill-timed. Right. Which is, I'm still, I did not take back my tweet. I did not delete it. But the media started again. There Zafarul Islam Khan has apologized for his tweet. I did not apologize for my tweet. But for its timing, that the country is undergoing an emergency lockdown, this and that. And I should not have spoken this because all the efforts are to contain this new kind of plague that is threatening us. I should not have spoken that.
Right, sir. So do you think, this is a slightly different question now, do you think there is a difference in the opinion of Zafarul Islam Khan, Dr. Zafarul Islam Khan, as the Delhi Minority Commission Chairman and a person that you are, the person, the personal experiences you've had, the personal views that you have? And do you think that you're able to keep these two views and these two opinions very separate, or are you not?
You see, you cannot separate a person from his history. It's not possible. But I have been very conscious. Every time we took any big decision, we always went to the act. There is an act which says you can do this and you cannot do this. The day I went there, on the first very day, when we held a meeting with the two members, that we enter here and we leave our religion on the gate. I am not a Muslim here, and you are not a Christian here, and another member, you are not a Sikh here. But I must tell you that a lot of people did not like my work because we were taking note of Hindutva politics, the hate politics. We took note of what was happening in Northeast district. We took note of these Trishul Yatras and this and that. We took note of attacks on madrasas or mosques or this kind of provocative things. So they did not like these things. I know this is not thing. And I may also add here that the real purpose of all this propaganda against me was to deny me a second term. And I must tell you also that they have succeeded in this.
You had also tweeted, I noticed that appropriate legal notices have been sent to news channels that distorted your statement. Who are the news channels you've sent to, sir?
I have not sent to all. I have sent, right now, I have sent only to Times Now, which started it all. They championed it all. And they distorted. And they changed these things. They said, I'm inviting Arab countries to interfere in India. It changed Hindutva bigots to Indian bigots. It did it. And so many things. There's a long list. And I will take this channel to court.
Right, sir. So my next question is, you've been booked for sedition. And as you know, that no government, no police can book a citizen for sedition till the state government does not give them the permission to go ahead. For example, with the JNU case also, and the permission was held for very, very long till after the Delhi elections.
I have no knowledge that they have given any permission. I don't have any knowledge. I don't think. And here there are some more complications. That according to the National Minority Commissions Act, I am a public servant. And to prosecute a public servant, you need a specific permission from the state government. And also, our act says that the commission chairman and members also have indemnity. They cannot be sued. Cannot be legal and criminal action. They cannot be taken against them for any act which they did in good faith. And in any case, I would like to tell you also that top most legal luminaries in this country have contacted me, or through people, they have said that there is no case here and this will fall flat in any court.
Sir, you said this interesting thing about the Delhi government, right? About how they have to explicitly give permission, considering that under the DMC Act, the DMC 99 Act, if I'm not wrong.
Yes.
You have certain protections. So have you been able to get clarity with any Delhi government personnel regarding these or not yet, sir?
No. You see, it is beyond my dignity to go and ask such questions. I will never do that.
Okay.
It is for them to take any action, and I will not interfere. I will not use any intermediaries or anything like that. I don't do these things.
Do you think you're going to be removed before your term? Do you think that might happen?
It is up to them. I'm not going to lobby anybody. I'm not going to ask anybody. But if they want to remove me, I mean, no problem. I will sit in my home and I have a lot of work to do, which is actually suffering because of these 3 years. My own work has suffered a lot. See, I am also an author. Something like 40 books are, you know, in various stages. I could have completed them. And so if they remove me, they are welcome. But I am not going to resign.